Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters, your brother Muslih Khan. Today let's talk about the niqab. The niqab has been a subject in mainstream media throughout the world, and it's important for you and I as Muslims to really understand what the niqab is and where it fits in with respect to our religion. Niqab comes from the word nuqba, and nuqba literally means a garment that has tiny holes in it. This is why you see some of the sisters who do wear the niqab, they cover the entire face and just their eyes are exposed. Then depending on where the niqab is, so if you have a garment that covers the nose, it has a separate meaning. And if it covers the nose, it has a separate name. So niqab has different variations to it. So what we want to talk to you about is the most common style of the face cover, which is really inclusive of the nose and most of the eyes, and maybe for some sisters, even the eyebrows is exposed. So what exactly does the niqab mean with respect to Islam, and what have scholars said about this? The first point, brothers and sisters, is that scholars have always differed on the ruling of niqab, not the permissibility of it. Anybody who thinks that niqab is not part of Islam really doesn't know what they're talking about. Because if you look at all of our Islamic history, from since day one, the Prophet ﷺ was always talking about this face cover. And then he made certain exceptions to it. So when you're praying, you don't wear the niqab or cover the face. When you're in the state of ihram, you don't do it as well. So there were exceptions to this rule. And even we have some narrations of the Prophet ﷺ describing certain women, and he would describe the colors of their cheeks. How would he know that? This is to show you and I that there were even some women during his time that didn't actually cover their face. And what's more important, the Prophet ﷺ didn't order those women, make sure you have your face covered. That's important to note. And because of these narrations and these incidents, scholars have differed on the ruling. Some have still said at the end of the day that niqab was wajib. Others have said it was highly recommended. Yet others have also said that it was permissible, and in some extreme cases, niqab was actually disliked. So you were discouraged to wear it under extreme cases. So let's just try to understand each of these categories. Wajib, think about it. You go into a country or a society where 95% of the women have their faces covered. You waltz in now, everybody starts staring at you. You become actually a fitna or a problem for the people within that society. Here's where scholars said you should really use your wisdom and wear the niqab, and you should treat it as though it's compulsory for you, because that's the culture of the people there, so you should try to fit in as best as you can. It's a bigger problem if you stand out, so you want to eliminate that. Other scholars said, no, it's always recommended, meaning if you do it, you get a reward, but if you choose not to wear it, then inshallah there's no punishment on you, you have a choice in the matter. The third opinion is just completely permissible, it's mubah. Do it if you want, don't do it if you don't want. You're not punished, you're not rewarded. It's all good at the end of the day. The makruh one is interesting because that really depends on the circumstance that you're in. Sometimes, depending where you are in the world, the niqab is a real hot issue, and sisters who wear the niqab are targeted for whatever reason, and it could actually be very dangerous for them wherever they go, whether it's in a grocery store, in the subway. It could be a very dangerous situation, and they're singled out from anyone else. In cases like that, scholars say it's disliked for you to wear it because you're actually creating a bigger problem for yourself, so you try to abstain from that. Now, where is all of this coming from and why? What all of this means, brothers and sisters, is that it's painting for you a picture to think about where niqab is in this religion. We don't have an exact ruling of what niqab really is. So at the end of the day, the majority opinion is that niqab is mustahab. It is actually a good thing. And the sisters who choose to wear the niqab, these are sisters that are honored, they are rewarded, and they have attained, insha'Allah ta'ala, a higher level of iman. Now just think about it. Give the haq where haq is due. So when a woman walks out in public and she covers her face, this is a higher state of iman. It's a higher state of consciousness that she has with Allah Azza wa Jal. She is rewarded for that bi-idhnillah. At the end of the day, if the woman chooses not to wear it or she wants to take it off the next day, that's her choice as well, and she's not punished for that. And that seems to be the majority opinion amongst the ulama, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Here's the final thought that I want to leave you with. If you want to wear niqab, wallahi, brothers and sisters, especially the sisters out there, use your wisdom. Don't just wear the niqab because it's your own personal choice and you just feel like doing it. Really think about the greater good for yourself and those around you. If you're going to wear the niqab and get on a bus and travel 2 hours late at night, you better think twice, because that situation can be a pretty dangerous situation for you depending on where you live. So you want to think really for the greater good of what you're trying to achieve. And those of you who don't wear the niqab, don't despise it at the same time, because as we mentioned, it's part of our history. It's part of this deen, and it's here and it's here to stay. So at the end of the day, make sure that you fulfill the basics of your hijab. Make sure that you fulfill all the conditions of the hijab, and think about the niqab and wearing the gloves, etc. These are just extra elements as part of the complete perfection of that hijab. But at the end of the day, if you have complete hijab without covering the face or the hands and other parts, then at the end of the day, insha'Allah ta'ala, you will be rewarded for a good complete hijab. Just make sure you fulfill the 7 to 9 conditions of that, insha'Allah ta'ala. Again, brothers and sisters, this is just food for thought for you to think about. And as I mentioned to you, use your wisdom. See if niqab is right for you. Not every culture or every society, the niqab is the right choice. All you have to do is make the choice that I'm not going to wear this right now. Things are pretty heated on the news. There's a lot of attention with this particular garment. I want to stay away and make sure that I'm safe for myself and for my family. That's using wisdom. That's putting things in their rightful places. With that understanding, the niqab is going to make sense and it's going to be preserved, insha'Allah ta'ala. Actually, the last and final point that I want to leave you with is a small piece of advice for the niqabis out there. So those niqabis that are listening to this, remember that with your niqab, you've taken your hijab to the next level, which in turn, you should take the internal hijab you have in you to the next level. We're talking about your etiquettes. So make sure that you carry the responsibility of niqab. All too often, you'll see niqabis sitting together, but they're loud. They could be obnoxious in certain, depending on what they're talking about. They could be a disturbance to the people around them. You don't want to represent the niqab in that manner. This niqab requires a level of haya, a level of etiquette that is actually above what the average haya or modesty etiquette of the rest of the sisters that are around you. Remember, you've taken a step up, a step forward. So make sure that you internalize that within your etiquette, that you do the same. Take the responsibility of the niqab, and not only will you fulfill it, but you will feel proud as a niqabi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve all of you and protect you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.